Hey guys, Eric Kyle here, publisher of Great Lakes Scuttlebutt Magazine, and I'm excited to be down at the Miami International Boat Show right here in beautiful Miami, Florida on Biscayne Bay, and I love this show. By far my favorite show of the whole year. And while I'm down here, I'm kind of wandering around. I'm looking for some fun and exciting new products to report to you guys on, and have I got a doozy here. I'm here with Jeremy with Hydrohoist. Jeremy, how are you, brother?
I'm good. How are you? Having a good show?
Yeah, so good, far good, so good. Good. Hey, man, I'm in Miami. This is fantastic. And you guys over at Hydrohoist, we've known you for many, many years.
Yep.
Been advertising with us for a long time. There's a lot of our lake boaters that use your lifts currently.
You got it.
But this lift that we're on now, big news. Tell us about it.
The biggest news is the capacity. I know you interviewed with my father previously, and the ceiling was 18,000 pounds. It kind of closed us off from the big center console, the big express cruiser style boats that a lot of people are buying now. I mean, you see the size of the motors that are coming out this year.
Oh yeah.
This allows us to get into that market and pick up those boats with a 20,000 pound capacity and a 25,000 pound capacity.
25,000 pounds?
You got it. That's actually what you're on right now.
Well, so how big of a boat can this thing handle?
It really depends on the capacity because, I mean, you've got different outboard packages. You can get five on them now. There's a couple with six. So it's more about the capacity, but I mean, we've picked up 43 footers. We've picked up 38 footers in that range. It just really comes down to the capacity.
What's the beam on something like this? Can you expand it out, or does it have pretty much a set beam that you have to have on it?
Believe it or not, we can work with any hull configuration, and we can work with just about any style of hull. We can typically get out to about a 12.6 beam. We can stretch that a little bit depending upon what we're actually picking up, if it's a catamaran, a pontoon, or an actual V-hull.
Absolutely huge, man. And this kind of sets the bar way above what anybody else out there is doing right now. But the thing I love about Hydrohoist, Jeremy, is that the product itself is already light years in front of what everybody else is doing out there. Tell me why this lift system is the best that's on the market.
Well, and it's funny because the floating lift segment has always been a soft segment. They've never been real quality entrants in that segment. And everybody knows about cable lifts and elevators. They both have major drawbacks. Mm-hmm. We actually marketed against floating lifts, but now we're really going after that segment because it betters cable lifts and elevators in a lot. One is longevity. These tanks are roto-molded. They have a 10-year guarantee on them.
Okay.
When we're fully lifted, we're not touching any metal to the water.
Right.
So all of our metal is completely out. It is all marine-grade aluminum with stainless steel hardware and actually brass nuts, so we don't have the galding of the nut to the screw itself.
That's
this
important.
Also makes it easy to expand the lift later on, which you cannot do with a piling lift.
Okay.
We can actually pop in, add another set of tanks, and actually change the width to fit a new boat in just an afternoon.
So when I go out to the dock and I see a lift, there's a lot of things that I need to do to get my boat in the water. How easy is it for me to get my boat in the water with this lift?
Very simple. This box right here literally just has an up and a down. The other nice thing about this that's been a problem in floating lifts in the past is they don't stay level. You're typically either manually controlling with valves, or you're waiting until the lift is fully up and then it corrects its level situation. This is auto leveling using this unit right here, which is an accelerometer.
Okay.
That technology allows this unit to not get any more than 2 degrees out of level. And then it will actually change the valves to bring the unit up level. If you ever watch a time lapse, you can see small adjustments.
Yeah.
And it keeps that boat safe and sound. It also does that lifting and lowering, so it's not just only on the way up.
Okay.
This unit itself controls all of that. If you get outside of 10 degrees, the unit locks out and takes out that potential of lifting too high with the boat not being level. It allows you to lower it back down and safely get the boat back to the water and to find out what may have happened if you got the boat too far back, but it's something you don't usually see.
No. Well, first of all, I love the term accelerometer.
Yep.
That's going to be my term for the day.
Yep, just like your cell phone.
It's just, it's a touch of a button.
Yep.
I mean, that's it.
Yep.
So you're walking out to the dock, you're stepping directly onto your boat because you have these convenient pads right there. You're on your boat, you press a button, you're down, boom, you're out. You come back, press another button, and you're home.
Yep, and one of the big things you run into with most boat lifts is we work with the tides we have here.
Yeah.
You leave, if you leave during high tide, when you get back, your lift is too high. You've got to have something to get it down. You either have to get out or you have to lower it down so it's an extra step. Because we're riding the tides, because it's floating, it's down. It's welcoming you back. You just pull right in, raise her up, and you're done.
I love it. All right. So, here's the deal. If I can't make it down to the Miami Boat Show, Jeremy, where am I going to go online to find out more information about this new product and indeed the full lineup of Hydrohoist products?
You can actually look at it all at boatlift.com. They'll have all of the information ranging from the shallow lift to the ultra lift to the E-Series to the harbor hoist.
So whether you're on a small inland lake or a big great lake or you're out in the ocean, this is the kind of list that you need.
We got you covered. We got you covered.
You are the man, Jeremy. Thank you so much.
Yep, thank you for coming by.
Boatlift.com. Make sure you go by there. Check this out, guys. It is awesome. It's going to improve your boating experience. You're going to love your time out on the water, and you're going to love your lift. Thanks so much. We'll see you out on the water.